sisters, welcome back to my channel. We are going to read a story using this point goal. Point goal code. The point and goal interactive reader. Mickey Mouse and Toy Story. You need two buttons. Let's try Toy Story.
Humans are around, he and the other toys in Andy's room come to life. Woody reminds the toys to get a moving buddy so no one gets left behind when Andy's family moves. Then, Woody mentions that Andy's birthday party is today. All the toys, except Woody, worry that they will be replaced. Of course, Woody isn't worried, says Mr. Potato Head. He's been Andy's favorite since kindergarten. It's true. Woody even has a special spot atop Andy's bed. To help calm down the other toys, Woody sends the green army men to watch Andy unwrap his gifts. Using a baby monitor, the hidden soldiers send news to Andy's room. One present is a lunchbox, and another is bed sheets. Who invited that kid? Jokes Mr. Potato Head. Just then, Andy's mom pulls a mystery box from the closet. Andy is very excited. This makes everyone, even Woody, nervous. Unfortunately, the baby monitor breaks before the toys can find out what's in the mystery box. Suddenly, Andy and his friends burst into the bedroom. They knock Woody off the bed and place a new toy there. Then, the kids run downstairs for cake. Woody and the others climb onto the bed to meet the new toy. I am Buzz Lightyear, Space Ranger, the new toy declares. Buzz shows off some of the fancy gadgets on his spacesuit. The other toys are very impressed. What does a Space Ranger actually do? Rex asks. He's not a Space Ranger, interrupts Woody. He doesn't fight evil. Or shoot lasers, or fly. Buzz presses a button on his spacesuit, and wings pop out. He says that he is a real Space Ranger, and insists he can fly to infinity and beyond, says Buzz, as he leaps off the bed. ball, a race car, and a toy plane, Buzz appears to fly around the room. The other toys applaud wildly. That wasn't flying. That was falling with style, grumbles Woody. They'll see. I'm still Andy's favorite, he tells himself. But as the days go by, Andy spends all his time playing with Buzz. Andy even gives Woody's special spot on the bed to Buzz. Feeling upset, Woody tries to knock Buzz behind the desk where Andy can't find him. He sends Andy's remote control car, RC, racing towards Buzz. But Woody accidentally knocks Buzz out the window instead. The other toys don't believe Woody when he tells them it was an accident. What if Andy starts playing with me more? Asks Mr. Potato Head. You gonna knock me out the window too? Then Andy walks in, looking for a toy to take to Pizza Planet. Andy can't find Buzz. Joey grabs Woody. As Andy's mother starts the car, Buzz runs out of the bushes and leaps onto the car's bumper. When Andy's mom stops for gas, Buzz jumps through the sunroof and onto Woody. He's upset that Woody knocked him out the window. They tumble out of the car just before Andy's mom drives off. They are lost toys, totally alone. Woody worries he will never see Andy again. Buzz worries about saving the universe. You are a toy, yells Woody. Then he spots a Pizza Planet delivery truck. That's where Andy is heading. Woody tells Buzz that the truck is a spaceship that will help return Buzz to his home planet. They climb inside and soon arrive at Pizza Planet. Buzz sees bright lights, rocket ships, and aliens. Woody sees Andy and his family. Both Buzz and Woody are sure they will be home soon. Pizza Planet, Buzz mistakes the rocket ship crane game for a spaceship and climbs inside. Woody follows Buzz, but it's too late. The claw lowers and grabs Buzz. Woody tries pulling Buzz back down, but the squeaky aliens inside the game get in Woody's way. He has been chosen, they squeak, as the claw pulls up both Woody and Buzz. All right, double prizes, says Andy's neighbor Sid. Woody knows Sid can be cruel to toys. Sometimes he even blows them up. Let's go home and play, Sid cackles. And Woody home with him. Inside Sid's room, Woody and Buzz see that Sid has transformed his once normal toys into scary-looking mutants. Woody and Buzz escape into the hall. While trying to hide from Sid's nasty dog, Scud, Buzz hears, calling Buzz Lightyear, this is Star Command. Buzz checks his wrist communicator. But the voice is part of a television commercial for Buzz Lightyear toys. Buzz tries to prove that he's a real space ranger by flying like he did before. But this time, he falls to the ground. He's not a space ranger. He's just a toy. Woody finds Buzz and decides that they should escape out Sid's window. But Buzz doesn't want to help Woody. He's too sad. Soon, Sid returns. And tapes a large rocket to Buzz. that he and Buzz must escape before then. I can't help anyone, Buzz says. I'm just a toy. Woody explains that Buzz may be a toy, but he's a great toy. And that's why Andy loves him. Finally, Buzz realizes that being a toy is important. He's ready to help, but it's now morning and too late to escape. Sid wakes up and carries Buzz outside. Woody asks Sid's toys to help him save Buzz. We'll have to break a few rules, says Woody. But if it works, it'll help everybody. Sid's toys only look scary. They want to help. As Sid prepares to light the rocket on Buzz's back, he hears Woody talking. We don't like being blown up, Sid, says Woody. Slowly, all of Sid's toys come to life and surround him. Finally, Woody looks right at Sid and says, so play nice. Sid shrieks in terror, then runs into his house. His days of being mean to toys are over. Woody and Buzz quickly say goodbye to Sid's toys. Andy and his family are moving today. Woody and Buzz will be lost forever if they can't catch the moving truck. Luckily, they reach the truck and hop aboard. But Scud is right behind them. He chomps down on Woody. Buzz jumps onto Scud, saving Woody, but leaving himself stranded. Woody sends RC out to rescue Buzz. But Andy's toys think Woody is up to no good again. Toss him overboard, says Mr. Potato Head. Fortunately, Buzz and RC pick up Woody as they race behind the truck. The other toys realize that Woody and Buzz are working together. They stop being mean to Woody and try to help. The other toys are not able to pull Woody, Buzz, and RC into the moving van. Soon, RC's batteries run out. RC slows to a stop as the moving truck drives out of sight. But then, Woody remembers the rocket that Sid put on Buzz's back. He lights the rocket, and the three toys zoom towards the truck. RC lands safely inside. But Woody and Buzz soar high into the sky. Buzz opens his wings, separating him and Woody from the rocket right before it explodes. The two then glide down towards Andy's car. Buzz, you're flying, says Woody excitedly. This isn't flying, Buzz replies. This is falling with style. Drop in through the car's sunroof and fall safely into a box right next to Andy. Andy looks in the box and is thrilled to find his two favorite toys, Woody, Buzz. Andy gives both toys a great big hug. Woody and Buzz wink at each other. After all they have been through together, they are now the best of friends.
Bando in Toy Story. Thank you for joining me, guys. See you on my next vlog. If you're new to my channel, please don't forget to like and subscribe and ring my notification bell. So you don't miss any of my videos. Bye.